virgin coconut oil can help destroy the novel coronavirus. That's according to a study by Filipino researchers after months of experiment. Initial results showed compounds from virgin coconut oil and coconut oil decreased coronavirus count by 60 to 90% at low viral load. The compounds are also observed to improve cell survival. VCO is readily available in the Philippines, a coconut exporting country. For more on the study, let's talk to Dr. Jaime Montoya. He's the Executive Director of the Philippine Council for Health and Research Development at the Department of Science and Technology. Good morning, Dr. Montoya, and thank you for joining us this morning, sir.
Yes, good morning.
This is welcome news, definitely, at a time when there's still a lot of COVID-19 cases here in the Philippines. Talk to us about VCO, virgin coconut oil, and what's in virgin coconut oil that works so far against COVID-19.
Okay. Based on the studies that were done, these are basic studies done by, it was led by a Filipino scientist, Dr. Fabian David from the Ateneo de Manila University. It was shown that derivatives of the virgin coconut oil, which is what we call monolaurin, lauric acid, are actually the ones that are active against the virus. It has shown, and you already mentioned it, that it actually contributes to about 60 to 90% decrease in the number of viruses or the amount of viruses in the laboratory for as long as it is done when the viral loads are still low. In other words, if the virus numbers or amounts are already significant or big, it reduces its activity significantly.
And how much of VCO should be administered? And how is it administered, for example, to patients?
That is part of the question because, of course, the usual dose is 1 teaspoon, 1 tablespoon, 1 to 3 times a day. But we want to find out whether that is the right dose or dosage. And that is actually part of the clinical trials that are actually being done. Because I'd like to clarify that even if it works in the laboratory, we still have to see whether it actually works when it's actually given to people who are actually infected with the virus. So we have to check that by doing clinical trials in order to verify.
Has the clinical trials begun?
It has begun. There are two ongoing trials. One is community-based, which is happening in Santa Rosa, Laguna, and there was a new site added in Valenzuela. And then for the hospital-based study, it's being done at the UPPGH. So the ones in the community actually look at asymptomatic or mildly symptomatic cases, while in the PGH trial, they're looking at patients who are infected and who are hospitalized, moderate cases of COVID-19.
And how big is the sample size? Basically, the number of people covered by the clinical trials.
Well, in the community-based study, the sample size about 90. That's, of course, one given the VCO, the other half given standard of care. And then for the PGH study, it's actually lower. It's less than 80 patients.
When do you expect to complete the trials?
For the community-based study, it's supposed to finish, assuming that all the patients are in and they have been followed up, they completed the treatment of 28 days, it's supposed to finish by December of this year. Well, the one in PGH has just started, so it will actually continue up to first quarter of next year.
Mm-hmm. Now, talk to us about the actual mechanism of how, based on the laboratory findings, virgin coconut oil works against COVID-19. I mean, the exact mechanism, what it does to the cells, for example.
Well, because we actually tested the actual virus, it destroys it. So it destroys the viruses actually have a cover, a surface that shields them from attackers, from antibodies. It actually destroys that shield or that coat. Mm-hmm. And that is the activity of the VCO. And if you destroy the coat, then first, it is actually prone to destruction. And number two, it is not able to enter the cell because it has to have that coat because it carries the the receptor or the substance that makes it possible for them to enter the cell. And as you probably know, viruses need a living cell. Mm-hmm. They actually use the machinery of the cell to manufacture its own proteins. That is why it cannot live outside of the cell.
But by the way, who thought of experimenting on the possibility of virgin coconut oil working against COVID-19?
Of course, the scientists, this was led by Dr. Fabian Dairit from Ateneo de Manila, they looked at VCO against COVID-19 because other studies have shown that it is active against other viruses. So they wanted to find out whether, in fact, it will also work against the SARS-CoV-2, which is the causative agent of COVID-19.
So the funding was provided by the DOST, right?
Yes.
Okay. So once, let's say, the trials are completed and then this proves effective against mild and asymptomatic cases of COVID-19, how big would be the impact? Because if you look at the numbers, I think more than 80% are mild and asymptomatics, right? You only have a small portion of the population infected with COVID-19 that's actually severe or critical, right?
Yeah. Well, you know, it will be difficult for me to speculate where it's going to be used, how it's going to be used. The only thing I can say now, it has potential based on the initial studies. And we have to wait for the results of the clinical trial because we do not want people to have the impression that we're already saying that it actually works. We still have to do the finish the clinical trials for us to make a definitive conclusion as to whether it can actually help or not.
Okay, what would you tell, for example, the viewers now who might be thinking, hey, based on the initial results, VCO works against COVID-19, but some people might think even if they don't have COVID-19, they'll just start taking virgin coconut oil.
Well, you know, VCO as it is already approved by the FDA as a food supplement. So you can actually take it for whatever reason.
Okay.
But what we're saying is you should not depend on it to expect that if you have COVID-19 or maybe you're infected or you're sick, that will actually cure you of that disease or infection. So you have to actually still do the other things that is required and receive standard of care because this is still not an approved indication for COVID-19, the VCO.
So meaning people should still observe minimum health standards, meaning
yes,
be very, very
yes.
careful. Okay. Dr. Jaime Montoya, thank you for joining us, sir.
Thank you very much.